Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our Let's Play of Championship Motocross 2001 featuring Ricky Carmichael. I'm the Ninja Stalker. We go and get back into it. We selected O'Neill's, our clothing brand, but I mean, with this game, because the EPSXE or whatever, or something, the pixels just don't look good that you can't even tell if your character is wearing anything at all, or even if there is a character there. But we did pick our bike, which was KTM, and we are going to stay with KTM because we chose them for the career on amateur, and then for the amateur race, which was 125cc, and then we did a professional 125cc, and now we're going to be doing, 250cc. I'm checking my phone. I was messaging my friend. She sent me a message. She says, "Lol, you're such a guy." Well, of course I am. It was because I'm... Alright, so here's a little personal thing going on here. I sent her a bunch of funny pictures, right? And one of them was of this girl in like a purple shirt or something. She's got like these really big breasts or something. They're not like super, super big, but they're nice, you know? And if you're a girl, my apologies, but there's a joke to this, if you can understand that. And hopefully you're not like a hardcore feminist where you're like, "Oh, there you go, there's some guy talking about girls and breasts and this, da, da, da." Slow your roll and shut your mouth. But for the girls out there who understand or are cool, you know, and all that, like she is, she's cool. That's why she answered like that. I told her, I was like, "Yeah, the picture I just sent you with the girl," which wasn't a picture, it was a video, it was a meme, sort of. Well, yeah, it was a... So this girl, right, purple shirt, you know, she like, grabs her breasts, like touches them, and then, like, lets go, and then she goes to go reveal her shirt. She's pulling her shirt up, and you see, like, belly, which, you know, wasn't... when I say a belly, I don't mean, like, she was fat. I mean, you see a belly, so, because, you know, she pulled the shirt up, and she's getting just to the breast, and you can see, like, the shirt, like... It's not really struggling, but because she's got some big breasts. Again, they're not too big. If I had to guess, they might be like C's or double D's or something. But anyways, she's about to pull them. The screen like quickly flashes an image to like three guys in red suits, and it says, "No one expects the Spanish Inquisition." And in the background, you still see the girl pull her shirt, you know, but you can't see her anymore because there's this big image in the way, you know, and it was hilarious. I put it on Facebook, and a lot of people were laughing at it, and then I sent it to her, and she was like, "Oh my god, you're such a guy, you know? Yeah, see, LOL, oh my god, you're such a guy." Well, you can't see, but I'm telling you. And then I was like, "What do you expect?" yes. So, anyways, here we are with 250cc championship. Yeah. We're gonna get into it, and my freaking... Over here, do that, go here, go here, go here. Alright, Glen Helen, it's gonna be mud for 2.1 miles. San Bernardino, California. Right. So, exit, let's go and shop. Shop to drop. Thank you. Sprockets, we're gonna need you. We're gonna need you. We're gonna want you. And we're gonna want you. But I have to win my three races. Have to win three races to make up. Make up for it. Alright, so. Mud, brakes, fuel, engine, sprockets. Alright. Let's win this first race. We got first place on all of our professional 125cc. Let's try and get first place on all of our 250cc. Alright, we got the hole shot. We're gonna double hit X, or the accelerator, to pick up some speed. Whoa there! Side there. I gotta remember that one song, we can't have that one song. Now I did upload the last Let's Play of me using the KTM, which I was able to avoid that one song and only had a little bit of the intro of that song play with no words, and it worked out. It didn't tell me that there was a block or claim it just because they heard the beats. And it's likely because I stopped it in time. So jump up to like 77 miles an hour when we do that double tap. And again, I don't know if that was a standard mechanic in this game that you can do that, or if it's because of the engine, or if it's because of the fuel. I haven't actually tested it, nor do I want to test it, because I'm glad that I figured it out and found out. Well, that, not that I figured it out, but I just happened to stumble upon it. I did not know about this when I first played this game way back in the day. I was lucky that hitting the wall there didn't actually flip me out of the bike. Oh my god, don't do that, please, don't do that. Yeah, this 250C class, it's something else. I've mentioned that before, but it's true. Now, the only problem I'm going through right now is I'm trying to remember the song that I'm supposed to skip, because I don't remember it. I had it in my head all day the other day. We didn't get new lap record though. Fuck. Sucks. Money better, but that's not. Alright, I am the only KTM this time around. But last time there was a total of two KTMs, right? There was me and somebody else. There was three Kawasaki's. There was one Yamaha. And was it three Reds? This time we got the Suzuki instead of the Yamaha, so there's no Yamahas in this. and one KTM, and everyone else is three for Honda, three for Kawasaki, one for Suzuki. Now, of course, in this game, they don't call them Honda, Suzuki, and Yamaha. They're called Blues, Reds, Yellows. The only people that they have sponsored in this was KTM and Kawasaki. But we know. And there we are, we secured first place. One win, 15 points. We could lose it next time. Oh shit, we got Carmichael in this. He's gonna be an issue. That's Ricky Carmichael, we got him in this. Alright, so we won the first one. Let's continue. Hangtown, Sacramento, California. Ooh! Is it this track that has that one song I have to skip? It might be. It might be this one. Alright, so let's go to the garage. Let's see what we need to do. Tires. We still got mud, which is good. We still have brakes, which is good. We need fuel. I mean, we could go standard fuel, but no. We got the engine's real good. And the sprockets are real good. So the next things to go would be the tires, the brakes, and the fuel. And what we need this time around is just fuel, I believe. Alright, pit crew, let's put this in. Bum na na, bum ba da 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 bum. It might be this one. Is it this one? No, this isn't a song. Alright, we got it. It was, the last time I played, though, it was on this map that song popped on, so it's probably going to be a different map. Yet. Is it Carmichael over here? Is this Carmichael that's being difficult with me? Now whenever I see a Kawasaki, I'm like, ah, it's Carmichael. It's gotta be Carmichael. He was in second place last time. Woo! Woo! Oh, shit. My cat's crying like a bitch. Jesus! Leo, if you want to get in, just open the door, dude. The door's cracked. It's not actually closed. Piss me off. Shit, Carmichael's like right next to me. I believe it's Carmichael. It's gotta be Carmichael. We will find out when he passes me and wins, or if he ends up being in second place, that it's him in second place the entire time, you know what I'm saying? Jesus, no! They told you, Leo, that's all you had to do, was just open the door. I didn't actually turn to see my cat open the door, but now from my peripheral vision, I see this door open. I'm like, oh, it's him. Get off the side. Come on. Okay, so triangle changes, what do you call it, your camera angle, makes it, like, closer. Oh, no. No! Oh, well, it's a Honda this time that passed. It might have been Carmichael, though, landing right behind me. out of the way. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. We'll find out. Carmichael might be in third place, or he might... Oh god, he might make it into second. Oh god, I hope I didn't do that to him. That'd be kind of fucked up. That guy landed wrong, though. Turn! Come on, come on, come on! Woo, there we go. And it was a Honda, then another Honda, then another Honda. Kawasaki, 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 and then Suzuki should roll up somewhere. There it is. Alright, so we didn't get the new lap record, but we did win. We got the money, and we need one more win to make up for the KTM. Carmichael came in 7th? Oh, man. Carmichael dropped to 3rd place overall. Now I'm securing 1st place for our team. Look at them pixels. Look at this. I really don't know why it's like that. Alright, so let's move on to the next round. High point. Okay. Which is sand. We need some sand tires. Sand tires. Brakes, fuel, engine is good, and sprockets is good. Alright, so shop, plug, sand, sprockets is good, that's good, base fuel, brakes, and that should be it, right? Yep. The garage, that, and everything else should be fine, yeah? Engine, yep. Start the race. This is the song. Made it. Yeah, I know. I weigh a lot of dough. What a waste of time. Oh god, get off of them. God, get off of the side. 250 in sand is kind of difficult. Dude! Piece of shit. Now how am I supposed to win now? Fucker was like right in front of me hitting the brakes. He's like, yeah, try and get around, dude. Try and get around, huh? Slowing you down, huh? Dude. Fucking piece of shit. Fuck, how am I gonna catch up? I'm gonna take a loss, guys. Maybe there's still hope, I don't know. Piece of shit. I'm telling you, this game will find ways. It was like, the best way we can stop this guy is to get in front of him. Slow down, hit the brakes. We'll be right back. I can see him. I can see him. I can see him. So, you try to have that guy stop me, huh? You try to have that guy slow me down. How much were you paying him, huh? How much were you paying him? Half of what you made? Half of what you made. Is that how much you were paying him? Because I could tell you, working with Kawasaki, you were going to give him, like, what? 250? Son of a bitch. And then everyone else catches up. So somehow, by some miracle, we caught up. By some miracle, we caught up. I think it might have something to do with that that boosting thing or whatever. When you hit the accelerator a couple times, and you like start speeding up. I think that's the really only reason. Because otherwise, I probably would have never caught up. The AI would have just been up ahead, so far away. But now that we caught up, notice how everyone else is catching up. Because it's a player instead of a PC, an AI component of the game. Oh man. And we got the new lap record. Alright, so we got some good money coming. E. Lust. And J. Dow. Was it J. Dow, the one that we passed? Was it you, motherfucker? Thought you can get that win? Cheat your way by having... Was it E. Lust that you had do that bullshit? Slow me down? Try sound like Danny DeVito and say everything that you can think of, you know? Just go around your house sounding like him. Oh boy. Let's see. Brakes. We still got these brakes that are good. We need fuel. We need engine. We need sprockets. Fuel, engine, sprockets. Shop. Alrighty. Right, this time we made out with an extra 100-ish, maybe? I don't know, because last time it was 6,100 and something, now we're at 6,275. Anyways, let's go to the garage. Tires, brakes are good, fuel, put that in. Engine, put that in. Sprockets, put that in. And, yep, let's get into it. Southwick. this. Nope, this ain't the same. Alright, got it. So I think the bike wants to settle at about 60, but then when you do that acceleration boost, it'll go up to the 70s. That's what it seems like to me. Never mind, I think it tries to settle at like 70, 71. And then when you boost it, it can get up to about 78, 79. Oh, I hit 80, okay, so that's like the fastest I've seen a bike hit. Oh, that's the fastest. There should be like a record for that too, yeah? Like, a record on highest speed on the motorcycle or the dirt bike for certain maps or something like that. Because don't they do that in baseball? They'll check how fast the ball's gone when it's been thrown. Carmichael came in second.
Miami. Oh boy.
Hard pack, alright. Now, what do we need? What we need is hard pack tires. We need brakes. We need fuel. Engine is good. Sprockets. Loading Miami. Alright, Miami. Okay, got it. Oh my god. No, what's going on? Oh shit, come on. Oh! Oh no. Messed up many times back there. And we got the new lap record. Oh, just like, look at the scores. It went 49, then 54, then all of a sudden 45. It's like, whew. Alright, Carmichael came in sixth. We held our position at the top. Alright, we're winning the hard packs. That's been a staple of ours, guys. A staple of ours. Now we're going to Unadilla, New Berlin, New York. Unadilla. Mud. Damn mud. Mud. We don't need brakes, but we need fuel. We need tires, fuel. Okay, shop. Need mud. Yeah. That's pretty much it. Garage to put these tires on. Alright, I gotta hear the song, see if it's here that they're gonna play it. I think it's like set on random. Nope, this ain't it. Alright, we got it. These guys all of a sudden go passing me. Whoa! He fell off in midair though. I don't know. How the hell that happened? You don't normally fall off in midair. These motherfuckers are all against me. Every single one of them. And it was a Kawasaki that did it. Was that Carmichael this time who wanted me out? Carmichael's like, nah man, you gotta lose one. You can't be winning them all. Fuck that shit. When I get up there, I'm beating all your asses. How am I gonna do that? You're gonna see the rear end of my vehicle. You're gonna see the rear end of my dirt bike. All you're gonna see is the exhaust and mud and tires. And you're gonna know that it's a KTM that beat the shit out of all y'all. There's that guy, but I don't know what he is. Is he in a Honda? Yeah, it's a Honda. So did you strike a deal with all these people? That's why they all did what they did? Miserable bastard. You couldn't just try and win normally, huh? You had to fucking cheat your way. Everyone saw what you did. Shit, I need to get in front of you. Oh no! Oh my god. Oh my god, all these people, they're like, no, slow them down! Slow them down! So I can secure second place, but I need that first. I need to win it. Fuck, he won first. Haha, funny guys. Real funny bitches. I got the whole shot, I got the new lap record, but oh my god, fucking E-Lust. One fucking win. Fuck every one of y'all, you bunch of cheating bitches. Bud's Creek, we're going through mud. We have mud tires, right? Yeah, we have mud tires. We need brakes. We need fuel. We need engine. We need sprockets. Oh boy. We need a whole 9 yards, and we didn't win it, guys. We did not win it. Oh. $6,000. We lost fucking money because of these pussy bitches playing these fucking games with us, y'all. They're gonna all be real fucking salty when I win this race. Oh shit, wait, wait, is this a song? I think this is a song, I'm not sure though. Yeah, this is the song. Okay, so we'll go over here, do that. Y'all are all gonna be fucking salty when I win this. Y'all thought I was salty? Nah, nah, nah. It's you guys that are gonna be salty. Y'all are gonna be sent straight to Salt Lake City, Utah. Y'all are gonna be looking for some water to get rid of that saltiness. We were thirsty for the win. Tried bringing all that saltiness to me. Mm-mm. All of them. They all like turned to look at me because I was the one in the middle. They're like, yeah, that's him. We got him last time. We got him last time. He must be pissed. It's going to throw him off his game. Nah. Nah. I still stayed there looking straight, right? You're like, oh, you remember that movie, with Paul Walker, was it the second, Too Fast, Too Furious? Where he was at the race line with the other three, and then they all turned to look at him, and he just, like, you know, snapped or cracked his neck or something like that? Like he was ready for this shit? Yeah, that's exactly what happened with our character. They all looked and they were like, oh, salt motherfucker. And then as soon as I sped off, they were like, oh, fuck. I thought you had him this time. Weren't you just supposed to turn his engine off by reaching over to his handlebars and, you know, doing that thing? You know, just turning the switch off? I couldn't reach. I couldn't do it. Yeah, well, look at him now. He's passing all of us. It's like, let me get this straight. No one's his friend, right? No one decided to make friends with him or anything? No, we were against him because we got tired of him winning and stuff. Oh, boy. We all done fucked up. And he's not the type to be trusted. Oh, no. Now, see, when I win championship, it'll be me, my crew, my viewers, and that's it. Fuck all y'all. A bunch of rat bastards. Oh, God. Should be kicking mud up in their face and shit. Everyone just got mud in their face. Suck it, jabronis. look at them. Oh, fuck. Ah, shit. That's why they did that side thing. They're like, ah, fuck. See, that's why everyone's going up ahead of me and not coming back here with me. Like, ah, fuck. They're trying to have a meeting right now. All right, guys. What are we going to do to get rid of him? All right? We're going all out. Somebody kill the guy or blow up his gas tank or some shit to where he's out in the middle of the race and he burns. I want to see his ass cook out there. That shit ain't going to happen. My crew's on top of their game. They're the best, all right? My crew, my viewers who are part of it, they're in on it with me. They're gonna make sure that the security is down packed. They in on that. Y'all must look at it. Look. They down there having a meeting right now. Punk bitches. That one fucking win. One fucking win. E-Lust. One fucking win. Bitch. Why can't a thunderbolt, you know, come from the sky and hit every one of them? Anyways, let's go to Red Bud. It's gonna be in the mud. Red Bud with some mud. We need some mud tires. We don't need brakes. We need fuel. So we need tires. Fuel. Tires and fuel, huh? Okay, let's get into it. Oh, we didn't get the whole shot. Someone else got it. You know what else they're gonna get? Disappointment, because they're... Oh, that motherfucker. It was the Suzuki that did it. The son of a bitch. He was like,
no one likes the Suzuki of mine. That's why there's only one of us, man. I gotta make sure I can do something so Suzuki is good.
No, again, nothing against anyone who has a Suzuki and all that, but, you know, you see the bullshit I gotta deal with. I'm in 5th? 5th? These bastards. A day of reckoning, motherfuckers. There's that piece of shit. I wish I could, like, hit him off of his bike, son of a bitch. That meeting that they had, they were like, yo, Suzuki, take one for the team. Even if the cameras catch you, just take one for the team. He was like, I'll try and make it look like I didn't hit him, that it was an accident, that my bike just happened to run into him, you know? Like he was the one who got in the way. Nah, motherfucker. Ain't no fucking accident. Yeah, like, that wasn't a fucking accident. Come on now, he could have gone around me, but no. Look at those turns he's taking, man. And the only thing I can get to help out is, these boosts or whatever. Dude, get the fuck off of me. Oh my god. Fucking... That's what you get. That's all they needed was for me to fall. They were like, we need him to fall, that way we can get past him so he can't catch up. That was it. Because once they get these turns and all that, that's pretty much it. Final lap. Oh my god. There's just no fucking way. Just no fucking way. I'd be fucking damned though if this Suzuki wins. Son of a bitch was the one that ran into me. Fuck you, motherfucker. Oh, please, please. Let there be something. Let there be something that he pretty much stays back and that I can make it in the first. Please. Let the guys in front of me like fuck up somehow. All I get is a new lap record. I didn't get the whole shot. I didn't get anything. Except for the new lap record, of course. But, oh, God. Who won that one? Jay Dowd, huh? You motherfuckers. Oh, we're not getting first place in all the missions. So, sorry, guys. But these bitches. Alright, we need sand, huh? We don't have any sand tires, do we? Nope, we have to purchase sand tires. We need some brakes. We need fuel. Engine is still good. Sprockets is still good. Salty motherfuckers. They didn't like being in Salt Lake City. They didn't like it. I didn't get the fucking whole shot. Oh, so they starting already. Somebody fucking hit him. Take off. Look, you saw that. You saw that, right? Cut through the air like it was nothing. Yeah, that's what you get. There's KTM. Alright, so I was like, yeah, there's some KTM logos and branding that I saw in here in advertising, but where is it? And there you have it. Big ol' KTM. One for the team. KTM's the underdog here. Now, of course, you can say that the yellows are Suzuki's underdog as well. But no, fuck him, son of a bitch. Guy ran into me. Took me off my bike and made everyone else win that one. This motherfucker. We'll be right back. Oh god. Get off of me, dude. Jesus. Not while they're next to you, don't be doing stuff like that. Oh my god, fuck off. Saw that I fucked up, ran into me to slow me down even more. Fucking haters. That's all haters be doing, trying to slow you down in your tracks. They don't want you to reach starter. They don't want you to reach your goodness, but you continue on. Fuckers are like, what? Who and what the fuck is this guy? What is KTM? Oh my god, look at this. Is it just me, or is the computer stepping up their game? Is the AI, like, stepping it up just to try and throw me off? Do they have something against KTM or something? They probably want a Suzuki to help out. They're like, yo, this guy's been winning too much. You join us, and we promise you, people start liking your bikes. We'll throw out that info that your bikes don't suck. Really? I mean, my bike doesn't already suck, but I mean, if you guys want to help out, that'd be cool. Because, you know, Suzuki bikes is really, it's based on opinion, you know? Because, like I was reading that review, the guy said it's all really based on opinion. All bikes have their pros, all bikes have their cons, but this game, apparently they all just want to go after me. Okay, there's a finish line. Yeah! They're all fuckers, like all pissed off and shit. Salty ass. See, that one guy right there ahead of us, he's contemplating whether he should be with the group or not. He's like, look, this guy is wiping our asses on the floor. He's just killing us out here. I don't know if I want to be part of this, because he's got some fucking... He's just going to burn us for our transgressions of what we did to him. We're going straight to hell. This guy literally looks like the Ghost Rider, you know? He's looking at us with that penance stare. We're going to fucking hell, guys. I don't know if I want to be a part of you guys with this. And they're like, nah, you come up here, you with us on this. Remember, you ride or you die, motherfucker. That's what they were doing. And that's why I'm back here just looking at him. I'm seething, you know? You could tell I'm seething, you know? You're probably like, oh, you're salty too. No, these guys are more saltier than me, all right? I don't know if any of them has been to Salt Lake City, Utah, but that's where they're at. That's how salty they are. That's Salt Lake City right there. Me, that's, what's that salt that you get? You could buy at, like, the commissary or Walmart that's got, like, the girl with the umbrella and she's got, like, some salt coming off the back? Yeah, that sea salt shit? That Morton salt? Is that what it is? Yeah, Morton salt? That's me. I'm Morton salt pissed. They Salt Lake City pissed. They just fucking hate it, all right? Oh my god, this shit I talk about. Ah, god. If only I have so many actual viewers who can like listen and actually find my jokes funny and write comments and stuff. But it's whatever, maybe in the future. Anyways, fucking E-Lust and J. Dow. Alright, L.A. L.A. Alright, L.A. This is my place. Hard pack L.A. Hard pack L.A. Tires? Hard pack. Okay, we got our brakes. We need fuel. We need engine. We need sprockets.
Oh! Oh! No! Oh, fuck. I didn't buy the stuff.
I swear to God, I clicked to go to the fucking garage or the shop. Oh. Oh my God, why?
Hey, we got the whole shot somehow.
Turn.
Are they fighting each other? Hold up.
I have to wipe my remote because I am sweating because of the frickin'... No, we want that on. Because of the frickin' fact that I don't have my sprockets, I don't have fuel, I don't have the engine. This is a stock engine. Oh my God, anything can happen. Alright. It's not that my overall hand is sweaty. Yeah, see, max is 72, whereas before with the engine and the fuel, we can go up to about 80. And again, it's not, like I was saying, it's not so much the fact my whole hand is sweating, although that will eventually happen. It starts at the thumbs and fingers, right? And then it progresses to the entire hand. And I've had that for, I don't know how long that has been like that. I told that to my pops one time, and he's like, oh, you didn't get that from me. Maybe you got it from your mom, because he doesn't do that. And because of that, because I do that and that sweating out of my hands or whatever, how would you say? All right, so for my car, my Dodge Challenger, it's a stick shift, right? On top of the stick shift, I have a cloth towel because I know if I touch that stick shift with my hands, it will, I will sweat and then it'll leave these nasty looking, color, black or brown color stuff on the, you know, because like if you sweat on metal or leather or, plastic of some type, you'll leave this residue, right? Some of you might know what I'm talking about. The people who sweat and they handle remotes or controls and stuff, and you see all these nasty, this nasty, like, gunk shit or whatever.
Yes!
Look at that shit. Take that. I took, how many of them? Five or four, you bitches. One, two, three, four. I took four of you bitches out. Suck it, jabroni! Take your ass straight down to the SmackDown Hotel. Whew. Okay, we didn't get the new lap record. That's a given because we didn't have the... We didn't have the sprockets. But if it wasn't the sprockets, we definitely didn't have the fuel and the engine. That could have really helped. So. We won without that stuff. But it's because of hard pack. I'm good with hard pack tracks, you know. And I'd be damn if I was gonna lose that one. What was that? L.A. Yeah, I'd be damn if I was gonna lose L.A. or Miami. Fuck that. Those are my places. Whew. Oh man. Or 1.7 miles of mud. Oh boy. All right. We have mud tires. Brakes, it's stock, we need small brakes, so we need brakes, we need fuel, we need engine, we need that. Alright, exit this time, shock, alright, jeez. Sprockets, give me that fuel, give me them brakes. And give me that engine. The pit crew was probably like we just talked, right? So let's say some of you viewers are my pit crew people. We just had this conversation. It'd be like, all right, so this is what you need, man. You need this engine. You need sprockets. You need fuel, and that should be it. You'd be good for this next race. I'd be like, all right, cool, got it. And then all of a sudden, you guys watched me slowly, like it was a slow motion movie thing. I jumped on the bike and I was like, alright guys, see ya, and like one of y'all was probably like, engine fuel sprockets. And then I looked back and I smiled because it looked like you were smiling at me. And I was like, right? Yeah. And as soon as I got to the starting line, I'm revving and I'm like, oh. And that's when I turn and look at one of you guys at the sideline, just shaking your head like, it's not that meme where it's Patrick Stewart with his hand on his forehead, you know, face palm or whatever. It's not that meme. It's the meme where you just got like your eyes are sort of sleepy look, you know, like you're just like disappointed, but you're not like that entirely disappointed. You're just shaking your head, you're like that, and I'm like, oh shit. But then we won, and it was like the miracle on ice, you know, or maybe like the Mighty Ducks or some shit. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Anyways, exit, garage, here we go. All right, so we have mud tires, we need brakes, fuel, engine, sprockets. There we go. Let's get into it. Bimington, mud, even though it kind of looks like sand. Alright, hold up. My cat decided to door open like a dick. Alright. We got it. Dude, get off of me. Oh, like, block him. I'll take the win. Get off. And look at the turns. Who the fuck makes turns like that? Not even I. My only ace in the hole is that boost. And of course the engine and sprockets and everything else. Dude, fuck off. Alright, so I see two of them up ahead. What? That was barely enough of a bump to throw me off, but if the game wants to fuck me over, at least take me out to dinner. This is Suzuki, dude. Oh my god. And then these two. Fuckers are violent, man. That's what that bitch gets. Yeah. fuckers. I mean, I'm still first overall, but it's just bullshit that's involved here. Yeah, see, right there. I mean, I hit the wall originally, but then I caught up to get past him, and then the guy hits me. Why is that a problem? Well, because we've seen in this game that these guys can cut corners like no other. So if they can cut corners like no other, there shouldn't be a reason for any of them to be hitting you. Of course, me, I'm seeing that I'm hitting walls and stuff, but still. They gonna hit you, it's for a reason that they're hitting you, and it's because I was winning. Millville, sand. We don't have any sand tires, do we? Oh, we do. Okay. Brakes is still good. We need fuel. Engine is still good. Alright, so just fuel, huh?
The pimp game. You took it and you got it from me.
kicking squad essential. I'm getting by, I got the feeling that. Wash it all. Mud. Oh boy, mud. We need mud tires. We need brakes. We need fuel. Tires, brakes, fuel. Got the whole shot. Oh, I made first. I guess that guy landed incorrectly, the one who passed us. Yeah, I think he did, because I'm thinking back, what I just saw there was flashed by me, and it looked like there was a red bike on the ground, and a green bike, or a yellow bike, in front of it, or behind it, I mean. So somebody landed wrong. Jesus! I tried to hold it in, but I hear you really shouldn't be holding your sneezes in, and then I was like, fuck, if I close my eyes, I'm gonna wound up in a ball. God, can you imagine being a dirt bike racer and then you have to sneeze or some shit? And you know how your sneezes are, and you're like, fuck, if I sneeze, it's all over with. Or like, what if you had like a nosebleed that day, and then you know if you sneeze, the inside of your helmet's gonna look like someone got shot. You imagine that, you're like, oh god, I can feel a sneeze coming in, and it's probably gonna be blood and mucus everywhere. And it's gonna get into my helmet and mask, and I won't be able to sneeze. Imagine that, you got like the camera looking at your character because you just did something, and then like on the video it shows like a split second, your character does like a nod, and then they're like, did he just sneeze? And then there's like the next second they see like blood everywhere, like, oh my god! Oh my god. That could have been a win. That fucker was right there. hard pack for Boston, huh? What do we need? We need hard pack. Brakes are good. We need tires, fuel, engine. Alright. $5,000 because of these rotten motherfuckers we're up against, people. Oh boy. Boston on hard pack. Well, we should win this one. Care to win? Hard pack? All right. Carmichael came in second. He's in third overall. Steel City. Mud. Brakes, fuel.
From the people at the top, take life into hands, take the losers out of the way.
didn't get the whole shot, but I mean, oops, I was looking at the wrong thing. You saw that, right? You saw that turn that he did in mid-air turn that he did. Okay, so at least the benefit that we get from them being as aggressive and accurate as they are in mid-air for turning, that on small bumps, sometimes they can fuck up. I don't see how. I've never fucked up on a small bump. Shit, I thought that was it. I was about to like let go, and then it was like final lap. I was like, wait, what? Okay, so that'll slow it down. Oh! Lucky. I should get a four-leaf clover tattooed to my ass for just what happened there, you know? As a matter of fact, funny story about that. One of my friends, actually the one who was in the military, or is in the military, the one I told you about who went from Navy to Army, and we were like communicating, texting each other and all that, He like nicknamed me Lucky whenever we play basketball because there's a thing that I do in basketball that just baffles him and everyone else. Mostly him, because I've only ever really played basketball with him. I mean, I played basketball with my other friends too, but he was the one who likes basketball a lot. And it's like whenever I go to his house and chill back in the day, it was like we'd go out to do like some kind of sporting thing, and usually the sporting thing was always basketball. The other sporting thing we would do is just walk around town. We literally would walk around Manhattan, you know, it was awesome. Anyways, I'm not good at basketball. I don't really like basketball too much. I mean, I do have a basketball team, but it's just because I like them. It happens to be the same basketball team as his. It's the Miami Heat. Let me see. And actually, I think when it came to basketball, because again, I told you that story about Okay, so we didn't get the whole shot, but we got the new lab record arrangement. Okay, but like I was saying, for the basketball thing, you've heard me before mention about sports. The only sports I really like is soccer, because I've actually participated in soccer all my life. And I mean, I'm Spanish. What do you that's what you can expect from me. I don't know about other Spanish people, and it is sort of stereotypical if you're gonna go down that route. But I like soccer, and it's just in me to like soccer and play soccer. And I'm pretty good at it. Other sports, baseball, I don't like baseball. I played it one time, didn't really like it. My favorite baseball team would be the Yankees, but then again, that's about as far as it goes. Football, my favorite team would be the Jets, because, I mean, from New York, I picked the Jets when I mentioned that conversation with you guys. Basketball, it was the Heat, but I don't like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't really play basketball and understand it too well to actually just roll over the basketball, but like, who wants the game? You know, who wants the ball or whatever? No. But whenever we do play basketball, I don't like shooting threes or getting up close and doing a layup, because I suck at doing layups. I can't really jump that high. But there's this thing I do when I'm a distance away from the hoop, especially if it's like anywhere from the three-point line further out. There's this thing I do where I don't want to say like I calculate the shot, but I look at the rim and then I shoot the ball, but like it's not like a hook shot, it's like a trick shot, you know. I just like look at the rim, and it's because I'm right-handed, I always use my right hand. I like toss the ball from my left to the right, and then I'll just loop it up like a trick shot, and then just magically it gets in there. So every time that happens, he'll look, he's like, what the fuck? I mean, he's like, fucking Lucky Charms over here. Fucking Lucky over here. You know? And it's because, like, I do a little hop, too, you know? And in some Lucky Charms, you'll see Lucky do like, a little hop or some shit. And then, I said one time to him, man, like, ah, man, I ought to get, like, a four-leaf clover tattooed in my ass. He just starts cracking up and laughing. He's like, what the fuck? But it was hilarious. So Lucky, you know, for what happened here in this little let's play here. But okay, so we got the points. E. Lusk came in second, and then surprisingly, Suzuki made it in the third. Huh. And then you got Honda, Kawasaki, 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 Honda. When you look at it, it looks like it says Rick. Rick. Is it trying to say wrecked? Like you're wrecked, son? Wreck? It's coming in. Anyways, E-Lus, Carmichael, J-Dowd. Next round, please. Oh. Las Vegas. I was going to say Angeles, but this is Las Vegas on some sand. We need sand. We need tires, sand, and that's it. Tires, gas. I think I said sand and gas, and then I said tires and sand. Alright, so tires, fuel, we got, $6,050 left. That's going to the crew, y'all. It's going to the crew. It's our last match with KTM. We gotta win this. We got to win this and show all these motherfuckers. That they will burn for their transgressions. We didn't get the whole shot, which disappointing. Yeah, I know. Where I die. What a waste of time. I was gonna hit the accelerator, and I actually did hit the accelerator, like, you know, I double pumped it basically to get that boost, but then I was like, oh, there's a short turn up ahead.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Welcome to the Thunderdome! Those are this place. Oh, we got KTM! KTM up in the house with the advertising. What does this place look like? I mean, Thunderdome, wasn't that from, what do you call it? Mad Max? Right? But when I say Thunderdome, it's because it looks like a phone, it looks like a dome to me, and, probably is. And I'm like, yeah, it's a dome, and, you know, it's a Thunderdome. That's just badass. I don't know. Don't listen to me. Oh, and my speakers decide to switch about. Welcome to the Thunderdome. Trying to sound like Macho Man Randy Savage.
Macho Man Blade shit, son. Cream of the crop. Never be as good as Macho Man. Don't know when I come in, drop my final ball on all your sorry asses. I just won this match, punk. Step into a slim jam.
Look at him. Look at him.
Lost this match. You don't know when I'm gonna come around, bitch. I snuck up and won this first place video. For the playtime.
yeah, we didn't get full stop, but we got the new lap record and we won the race, ladies and gentlemen. We secured the final win. We did it for 220 points. Now, I think that's less points than I won on my first career for Kawasaki. I think for Kawasaki, I won 241. This one, 220, and it's because of these sorry motherfuckers. So we made it out with 220, but I think our 125cc career, we made more than we did on our first career on the Kawasaki. So, Helen, Hangtown, High Point, Southwick, Miami, then Butts Creek, Kenworthy's, but we lost Nadika, that's New York, I think, Red Bud, which, I mean, I don't think I've ever liked Red Bud. Then there was Los Angeles, we were not going to lose LA. Carmichael won Bimington. That's strange. Didn't Carmichael win Bimington last time on Kawasaki? When I played with Kawasaki? Yeah, in Miami we won. That's we are not going to lose. The high pack areas, we are just not going to lose. And then Boston was high pack too. So we weren't going to lose Boston. We won Steel City, which I think was sand or was... No, it was mud. And then Las Vegas was sand, yeah. So. Yep, there you have it. 120 for 125cc. Amateur was for 51. And then 250cc was 220. Not bad. Yeah. There it is, guys. Celebration. Won this. Yeah, give it up, alright, yeah.
Your number one.
this video again. No, I'm not sure, but I think for you to be like a dirt bike racer, it's probably best that you don't weigh too much, right? Because, you know, these dirt bikes only have so big of an engine, and the lighter you weigh, the faster it would be for you and your maneuverability and all that, you know? I'm not saying that it's a staple or anything, but generally these people don't weigh a whole lot, right? Because I think when we looked at the other racers, they were anywhere from 180 at most, down to about 150. Does that sound about right? Which is good for me because I'm within that range. Oh, that's just a video of somebody playing in a Kawasaki. I thought that was me the first time around when I said it, but it wasn't. Because I played with the KTM this time around. Anyways, we don't need to watch that. We've seen that last time. Alright, so is there a save button? There isn't, but we can save state right there. Options, race settings, memory card. Right, so that's it. We've completed with KTM. I was very, very happy with KTM brand and their bike. You know, of course, this is a video game showcasing KTM, and you know, video game's one thing, reality is another thing. But I liked it. You know, in this game, it did pretty well, and it sort of went with what this guy was explaining in the video that I was telling you about, the last video when I picked KTM originally for the 125, for the amateur championship and for the 125cc. I was explaining this info that I got from a review online of a guy explaining about the five brands, and he said KTM was like the fourth to last, right? Because he said the first pick he would go with is Honda, second is Kawasaki, third was, I believe, Yamaha. Fourth was KTM, and then dead last was Suzuki, based on opinion and what he's noticed and what others have told him and this and that. And for me, I went ahead and picked KTM because I was like, oh, you know, orange bike, it'll look cool online. You know, orange is a good color. Again, all the colors look fine to me. But, you know, orange just tickled my fancy at the moment. And then I was like, all right, KTM, let's find out more about it. And when I got his review and I was looking at it, it said that the bike would be able to rip and turn, take corners and stuff. I was like, okay, you know, the rip part means acceleration. The bike will have acceleration, and we noticed that the bike did have pretty good acceleration. I was satisfied with that. Not all the time though did I win on the acceleration when we got the hole shot. Right, we've missed a few hole shots. But a majority of the time, we got the hole shots, whereas when I picked Kawasaki, sometimes I was getting it, sometimes I wasn't, you know. I think I was getting it more times than I wasn't with the Kawasaki, but I think with KTM over Kawasaki, I got it more often. So there's that. The acceleration, it picked up real nicely.
the turning and all, it was, I think it was there much better than the Kawasaki. The only difference is, with the Kawasaki, even though I wasn't losing or hitting the walls as bad as I was with the KTM, because I have noticed that, some of you probably point that out, that, you know, not all the time is it the PC or the AI against you. Sometimes you're just hitting walls and giving them chances to pass you. I've noticed that too, and that's because of me hitting the accelerator a lot to give me the boost, right? But in the Kawasaki, I didn't do that during the Kawasaki, and I was still hitting walls with the Kawasaki. Whereas here, I was only hitting walls when I did the boost. So if I didn't hit the walls doing the boost because I didn't know about the boost, I probably wouldn't hit the walls at all with the KTM. So imagine if I had the Kawasaki and then I was doing the boost, how much more often would I be hitting walls? Because Kawasaki was known for speed, and I did have the speed. Whenever I was in front, I had the speed. So yeah, there's that. So up next, who are we gonna pick? We're probably gonna pick, who do we have left? We have Suzuki, we have Yamaha, we have Honda. We're probably gonna pick Honda, then we'll go with maybe Suzuki, even though, Suzuki was ranked last. I do like the yellow that Suzuki comes with. And then blue being one of my favorite colors, even though I like dark blue, navy blue, and this is just blue, you know? A lighter blue than dark blue or navy blue. We'll probably pick that last because I think Yamaha for the blues in this game, because they're not called Yamaha, they're called blues. I think Yamaha offers a decent price. Honda offers the most, then Yamaha offers the second highest. So we'll probably do that last. We'll go with Suzuki fourth, you know, and then Yamaha maybe last. I don't know, something like that. But I think I'm going to give Red a try and enjoy winning with that amount of money. But of course, we saw that Yamaha had their thing. Now, his review on Yamaha was that Honda is an overall good bike. From the guy's review that we read, the Honda has overall good bikes, that people keep coming back to it, that the parts fit, it's all perfect, it's good to go, basically. And to me, that tells me that it's a generally good bike, that everything should be above average for the bike, but it's not up there, you know what I mean? Because Kawasaki's going to have speed over the Honda, you know? KTM's going to have the acceleration over the Honda. The Yamaha is going to have... What would Yamaha have? What did I read for the Yamaha that this guy said? Was it handling and comfort? Or handling? And then Suzuki was dead last, but they were trying some new changes. That's what he was saying. And he says he doesn't know if the changes are good, but Suzuki is trying some changes, but their engine just isn't good and all that, so maybe that's telling us that our stock engine for Suzuki might not be good in this game. Maybe it's telling us that when you pick Suzuki, you might have to rely on upgrades more than you would if you didn't use them. You know what I'm saying? So maybe when we pick Suzuki on our amateur race, when we can't actually buy and shop for things, we might have a struggle trying to win first place. Maybe that's what is being implied, and based off of what I'm trying to translate for this game. Then again, all the bikes could just be good, and it could just be the human factor, me. It could just be me for this game. Maybe I'm the one who's doing good in certain races, and all of a sudden I'll have a bad day and then not know about it and blame the AI, you know? Who knows? But we are done with this Let's Play for KTM. We will move on to probably Honda next time around, and yeah, so when that comes, it comes, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really do hope I get a lot of views and maybe some people commenting some good stuff and enjoying, you know, really, that's all it is. But anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. You guys take care. You guys have yourselves a good night, alright?